Hi friends, welcome to my health tip of the day. Today I thought we'd talk about healthy habits and the perception of nourishing yourself and what that can do for you. So oftentimes self-care and nourishing yourself is so often depicted in a diet or the vantage point of deprivation. And I want you to get out of that mindset of deprivation and fear of missing out. When you start nourishing yourself, the first thing you need to do is just take a few moments to yourself in silence and really visualize what are the things that help you stay grounded and nourished and balanced and joyful. So you start from the vantage point of joy. And then from there, you start thinking about healthy habits that you incorporate every single day that isn't from the vantage point of deprivation. So for example, every day I drink warm herbal tea, preferably an anti-inflammatory mix of turmeric or ginger or mint. And that's a healthy habit that not only hydrates my body, but also calms me. Other habits include 8 hours of sleep. Who doesn't like wonderful sleep? So remember, your body is always trying to go for balance. Too much sleep can increase your chances of disease. That's over 9 and up is really negative for your body. Less than 7 is very detrimental for your brain. So studies show that if you want to continue with good weight management or even lose weight, you want to stick to 8 hours of sleep. And so some things that I've done to invest in myself is I have invested in blackout curtains right behind me. And also before I go to bed, I set my thermostat for 69 degrees, which is the ideal sleep temperature according to the Sleep Institute. So one of the biggest healthy habits that is most critical for your longevity includes who you are choosing to hang out with. This is where you should be extremely discerning because it really is critical to your longevity and keeping chronic disease away. So the people I like to hang out with tend to not buy into the victim mentality. So bad things happen to everybody in life. And we often forget that in Facebook where things are heavily edited and it's just snapshots of what seemingly seems like a perfect life. But really what you want to hang out with are those people who you can feel authentic and they're warm and they're always striving to better themselves. And even though bad things happen, instead of focusing on the why is me mentality, they focus on, all right, this happened to me. What can I do to empower myself? And what are the steps that I can do to help myself get into a better place? And you'll find that those people are extremely inspiring and empowering. So who you hang out with is so critical to your health, because if you're hanging out with people who get in the way of your own self-care, maybe they always have so many problems, or maybe they drink too much, or they keep you out late, you will not be able to be your optimal self. So my rule of thumb is I like to surround myself with healthy, happy people that are always trying to improve themselves in some way and also have a healthy lifestyle. It's really hard if you want to go and have a healthy lifestyle, but say your friends are not having a healthy lifestyle. I'm not saying to defriend them, not at all, but I am saying to put yourself in an environment where there are healthy people. So in my own journey of health and happiness, I've been a single mom for 6 years and a solo parent for 5. So that's a lot of responsibility on me. So I make sure that I'm around a healthy environment. And I do yoga, and I found a yoga studio that I've made friends with. And I also am active in mindfulness and meditation. So whatever balances you, brings you joy, and nourishes you, and you're not in the mode of deprivation, is going to be a really good starting point to incorporating healthy habits into your day every single day. So if you like this video, please follow me on YouTube under My Health Now. That's MAI Health Now. You can also follow me on Instagram. And thank you so much for bringing me into your journey of health and happiness. And I look forward to supporting you next week. Talk to you soon.